Able to get the first UFC win under the belt earlier. Give me an idea. I mean, what does that do for your confidence, you know, knowing that, hey, I got to win in the UFC?
But especially this win, made my confidence grow because, like, it's possibly, like, the hardest fight I ever had. I felt like I was dying after 1.5 minutes. So, it showed to myself that even though I feel like falling over and dying and the shit is falling out of my ass, I can still keep on going and grind out a win. So that was a very good win for me.
I always think it's interesting to watch a fighter from their first UFC fight to their second. I feel like that's a big chance for improvement, a big chance for change. I mean, what did you change between your first and your second UFC fight?
I tried to get down in my real weight class because in my first fight I fought the Preseris, who just won a fight in welterweight now against Zach Cummins. So yeah, and then I wanted to go back down to featherweight, so that was the biggest change, right?
It's interesting because you mentioned Preseris. I mean, do you kind of just write that one off? Because, I mean, he's not even really a lightweight, right? I mean, so when you look back at that, do you just go like, you know what, I'm not even counting that one. That guy's not in my division.
No, because, like life is a learning experience. And, like, as a warrior, you step up when somebody asks you to fight. And it gives me confidence that I can see a dude that is so big. I could keep him at bay for, like, 2.5 rounds. He was so big. And then he goes up and, wins a welterweight match. Like, that's just crazy. And I'm a featherweight, natural featherweight. So, yeah, that's just cool.
Crazy. Yeah. All right, so talk about this one. I mean, now you get a well-respected, you know, British guy. He's been a prospect for a long time. When they gave you the matchup, what did you think about it?
I think it's a challenge like everyone else is in the UFC. When you're in the UFC, you don't get easy fights. So, and I like good challenges, and this was a good challenge. So, yeah, let's do it.
Not necessarily exactly his backyard, but it's his home soil, right? I mean, do you think about that at all? Is it factoring, like, I'm going to be the bad guy coming in?
It doesn't matter. Like, and I know the English people, it's like, if you're from Manchester and you're fighting in Liverpool, it's almost like, if I come from another country and I fight in Liverpool and the dude I'm fighting is from Manchester, it's almost like I'm on home soil, of what I understand. So, it doesn't matter.
What do you think about his game in particular? When you break him down, what do you see?
I think he's a very athletic dude, very wild, but I don't think he's that technical either in standing, grappling, or wrestling. But he's very wild, athletic, and yeah, that's what I pretty much take out of it. Stylistically, I think it's like he's a very raw fighter, and I'm more slick. So yeah, that's how I see it.
Give me the idea. What's the goal here? I mean, like you said, you've been through battles. Fans love battles. But your body can't take too many of those, right? So what's the goal?
The plan is just come through blazing, half man, half amazing. I can't do anything else than that.